गुड इवनिंग।
टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम राइटिंग हाफ इक्वेशन। ओके, दिस इज
ओके।
चैप्टर 7 ऑफ रेडॉक्स। चैप्टर 7, रेडॉक्स रिएक्शन। नाउ यू सी हियर, दैट डे वी डिस्कस द हाफ रिएक्शंस। वी विल अगेन बिगिन फ्रॉम देयर ओनली। यू सी द रिएक्शन बिटवीन सोडियम एंड क्लोरीन। सोडियम एंड क्लोरीन दे रिएक्ट टुगेदर टू फॉर्म द सॉल्ट NaCl। ओके, so the first step is to write the balanced equation. You have to balance this equation. Can you see the screen?
Yes, I can.
Okay, first of all you have to balance this equation. Now I have balanced this equation. 2Na plus Cl2 gives NaCl. Now you look, NaCl, NaCl is a salt. Okay, it is composed of Na plus and Cl minus ions. So I am writing NaCl like this, Na plus and Cl minus. Okay, so there are two atoms of sodium and one molecule of chlorine. They react to form two molecules of NaCl. Now I am writing NaCl like this in brackets, Na plus ions and Cl minus ions, and two molecules, so I am writing two here. Okay, this is clear. Now suppose we have a box. Yeah, if you don't understand anything, please interrupt me. Suppose there is a box here. Nothing goes out of this box. Okay, now we will attempt to write the half equation for sodium. Okay, now in this box we keep two atoms of sodium, 2Na. Nothing goes out of this box. Now you see this equation, 2Na plus Cl2 produces 2NaCl. And what is 2NaCl? It is made up of two sodium plus ions and two chlorine minus ions. Okay, so you see left hand side is two sodium atoms and the right hand side is two sodium ions. Now this is the initial stage and this is the final stage. So we are making two boxes. We have written initially and finally. So in this box you keep two sodium atoms. Okay, and what is the final product, you tell me please?
For the whole equation or just sodium?
Just sodium only, because we are writing first of all we are writing half equation for sodium. So you please tell about sodium only. What is the final product?
2Na plus.
2Na plus. Okay, so in this box we have two sodium atoms and we have to convert, this is the initial thing, and we have to convert it into 2Na plus. So how to convert Na into Na plus? If we snatch one electron from this, if we remove one electron from the sodium atom, it will become Na plus. Okay, so here you see in this box there is two sodium atoms. From both of these atoms we will remove one electron each. So what will be left inside the box? Two sodium plus ions and two electrons. The symbol of electron is like this, E. You write E, and up above the E you write minus sign. Minus sign because it has a negative charge. Okay, and sodium, it has a positive charge of plus one. That is why we are writing Na and plus. Plus means positive charge. And electron, it has a negative charge, so that is why we write symbol of electron E and minus. This is the symbol of electron, E minus. Okay, so inside the box there was two sodium atoms and nothing goes out of this box. You remember just this. So now this sodium ion, two sodium atoms was there initially, and what is there finally? Please tell me in the box.
2Na plus plus 2E minus.
And you know, understand how this 2Na plus and 2E minus was created?
Yes.
How?
Because after the sodium reacted, it lost two electrons to gain a full outer shell.
Yes, that is how. Okay, so now this is the initial stage and this is the final stage. Okay, now what you see here, there were two sodium atoms, one atom, each atom lost one electron. This first sodium atom losing one electron, and this is the second sodium atom losing one electron. So what is left? Now we write sodium plus sodium. You see here, sodium plus sodium. Here we have two sodium and it is giving 2Na plus plus two electrons. So this is the half reaction of for sodium. Okay, 2Na is giving 2Na plus plus two electrons. You understand this half reaction now? Sama,
Yes.
do you understand this half reaction now? What is this Na and Na, two sodium atoms? Remember, nothing goes out of this box. This is a box and nothing will go out of this box. Initially, what was there? Two sodium atoms. And finally, what is inside the box? Remember, nothing will go out of this box. Initially, two sodium atoms was there. So you remove one electron. So what is left? Two sodium ions and two electrons. So initially you write on the left hand side 2 Na, and finally you write 2 Na plus plus 2 electrons. Now this is the half reaction from sodium. Do you understand?
Yes.
Please explain to me. You explain to me from this point. From this point, writing of the equation.
Basically, what's happening here, first for Na plus Cl2, we have to balance that equation. So it'd be 2Na plus Cl2, which would give us 2NaCl2. At the beginning, that it would be 2Na, just 2Na, but after the reaction, it would turn to 2Na plus E minus.
Just a minute. Yes. So you are writing the half equation for sodium. So 2Na plus plus 2 electron minus. Okay. So this is the half equation for sodium. Sodium. It's in your textbook also. You understand now this half equation for sodium?
Yes.
Now we will proceed to the half equation for chlorine. Okay. Now tell me, Sama, initially what is there? Sama?
For chlorine?
For chlorine. Please tell me, for chlorine, initially what is there, and finally what is there?
Initially there is Cl2, and finally there is 2Cl minus
2. What is Cl minus?
Cl minus is chlorine, but with 18 atoms.
Yeah, it is a chlorine ion, negative chlorine ion. Okay, an ion. Na plus is a positive sodium ion, and Cl minus is also an ion. Cl minus carries a charge of minus 1. Okay. So initially there is Cl2, and finally there is 2Cl minus. Initially there is one molecule of chlorine, and finally there are two chlorine ions. Okay. So now we will proceed to writing half equation for the chlorine. So Sama, tell me, for chlorine, what is the final product?
The final product would be 2Cl minus.
2Cl minus is the final product. Okay. Now what is happening? Sodium is giving here 2Na plus plus 2 electrons. Okay. So initially what is there? 2 electrons given from the sodium is present. Okay. 2 electrons given by the sodium is present. Okay. Now this, and final, what is for, now we are writing the half equation for chlorine. So finally, what is there? 2Cl minus is there. To produce 2Cl minus, this initially what chlorine ion is there, a chlorine molecule is there, Cl2 is there. Okay. And this 2 electrons given by the sodium is there. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Why are we adding the 2 electrons from the beginning? Because initially, isn't it just Cl2?
Okay. Initially, it is just Cl2. Okay. Initially, it is just Cl2. So how will you convert Cl2 into 2Cl minus? You tell, answer this. Think 1 minute. Take your time. How will you? You look here. You look at the pointer. Cl2. You have to convert this Cl2 into 2Cl minus. So what will be required to convert 2Cl2 into 2Cl minus? What is the requirement? You tell me, please.
I have to add 2 electrons.
Yes, you have to add 2 electrons. So until 2 electrons are not present, Cl2 will not be converted into 2Cl minus. Okay. If 2 electrons are... Yes, please.
But for sodium, we're saying it's 2Na, and we're not saying that first it loses electrons for it to become 2Na plus.
Okay, okay, okay. I will answer you. Okay. Now, to convert sodium, you tell me this. You look at the pointer here. To convert this sodium atom into sodium ion, what do you need?
I need to lose 2 electrons.
No, do you need anything else? Just you can snatch 1 electron and you can make a sodium ion. To convert this sodium into sodium ion, do you need anything extra?
No, just to lose 1 electron.
Yeah, you can just have to remove 1 electron. You don't need to add 1 electron here. You just need to listen. The electron is already present inside sodium atom. Okay.
Okay.
A normal sodium atom is there. Okay. A normal sodium atom is there, and you have to convert it into a sodium ion. So just you have to remove the ion. You don't have to add anything. Do you need to add anything here?
No, I need to remove.
Just a minute. You have a purse with you. Mm-hmm. In your purse, suppose you have 10 Kuwaiti dinar. Kuwaiti dinar is the currency of Kuwait.
Yes.
So you have to give 5 Kuwaiti dinar to somebody. So what you have to do? Just tell me.
Remove 5.
Yeah, remove 5. Okay. You just remove 5 in from your purse and give it to somebody. That is all. Now again, you have 10 Kuwaiti dinar in your purse and you need to give 30 Kuwaiti dinar to a person. Then what you will need to do?
I need to get another 20.
You need to get another 20 and then only you can give 30. Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is the case of first case. You have 10 Kuwaiti dinar and you have to give 5 Kuwaiti dinar. Okay. Sodium is there and you just have to remove 1 electron. Electron is already inside the sodium. And the second case, you have to give 30 Kuwaiti dinar. So you will have to bring 20 Kuwaiti dinar from somewhere. Then only you can give 30, na? Now look at the sodium. You have to convert the sodium into Na plus. So you just remove an electron, it will be, get converted into Na plus ion. Sama, is there any confusion? Please ask me.
Yeah, I don't understand what you're doing.
No, you are understanding this. Acha, in suppose it is a box is here. Okay, nothing goes outside the box. Okay, nothing will go outside the box. You have to convert this sodium into sodium ion. So what you will need to do?
I have to remove 2 electrons.
2 electrons, 1 from each sodium atom. So this way you will get, for sodium it is clear now. Okay. Sama, is it clear for sodium?
Mm-hmm.
Now this, forget this 2 electron. If you have to convert this Cl2 look at the pointer, Sama, you have to convert this Cl2 into 2Cl minus. How can you do it? It is up to you. You think. You have to suppose you have one, this, you look here, there is one chlorine atom and you have to convert into chlorine ion. You tell your own way, how will you convert a chlorine atom into chlorine ion and what do you need for that? Look at the pointer here. By adding 1. Okay, by adding 1 electron you can convert 1 atom into 1 ion of chlorine. Okay. So what is Cl2? So Cl2 is a chlorine molecule. It is made up of 2 atoms. Sama, mm-hmm. So if you have to convert Cl2 into 2 chlorine ion, how will you do it? You tell me your own way. You think of your own, something
I
from your,
added 2 electrons.
by adding 2 electrons. Okay.
Yes.
So now this is the final, now you have chlorine, huh? And you have to, this now this is 2 chlorine ion is there. Finally, you have to, you need this 2 chlorine ions. So what you have, what things you need to get, what things do you need to make 2 chlorine ions?
Wait, I understand this part, but I don't understand why in the chlorine you're saying initially we're adding 2 electrons, even though initially it's just a molecule. But in the sodium, you put the plus two and on the refinery.
Okay. Listen, the cases of both are different. Okay. Sodium you can convert into sodium ion just by to convert. Just don't look from this initial and final point of view. Okay. You tell me your own way. If you have to convert, you think of your own new way. You have to convert a sodium. We are looking at this equation here. Okay. You have to convert this sodium into sodium ion, two sodium atoms into sodium ion. You tell me your own way. How will you do it? From your own idea, you tell me.
To convert it, I have to remove 2 electrons, one for each sodium.
Yeah. So if you now, so if you remove 1 electron from each sodium atom, you will produce this sodium ion. So this is how this half equation from sodium is written. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
Okay.
I understand what it starts as and what it ends as, but I don't understand why for sodium in the results we're adding the electrons, but for chlorine in the initial box we're adding the
Sama, don't, now this
electrons.
initial and final thing, it is creating confusion. So don't look from this point of view. Forget this initial and final. Okay.
Okay,
Forget
but this
the.
part I don't understand.
Okay, I will tell you. Just you simply think, you have to just think about sodium and chlorine atoms only. Leave everything else. Okay. Just think from the point of view of sodium and chlorine atoms. Now you have sodium and chlorine atoms are there. You have to convert this sodium into sodium ion. So what you will do? You will remove 1 electron. By removing 1 electron, you will convert sodium into sodium ion. Okay. This way, half equation for sodium will be written. Okay. Now you have to convert this chlorine into chlorine ion. You think of your own way. How will you do it?
I would have to add 2 electrons.
Yes, you will have to add 2 electrons.
Okay, I understand this.
You have to convert this chlorine into chlorine ion. So you cannot do that without adding 2 electrons. Can you do it without adding 2 electrons?
No, but I also can't make sodium a sodium ion without removing 2 electrons, but I still write it after the arrow.
Okay, you take your notebook. Write this
Okay.
equation. You write this equation. Na plus Cl2 gives NaCl. Now you have to write the half equation for sodium now.
I know how to write it, but I don't understand why I'm writing it like this.
Why you are writing it like this? Because what happens, Sama, in while writing half equations, you need to show the electronic transfer. Okay. The sense of writing half equation is, in half equation you have to tell what charge transfer takes place. Okay. So you would, now you have written the balance equation.
Yes.
Now you first of all write sodium.
It's put an 2Na around 2Na plus B minus. And for chlorine, it would be Cl2 plus 2E minus would be 2C. But I don't know why.
You don't know why?
Yes.
Sama, you write, again you write Na. You just in your copy write Na, 2Na, put an arrow and write 2Na plus. Now you tell me the way this Na will be get converted. How will you convert the Na into Na plus?
By removing two electrons.
So initially, if two sodium ions, sodium atoms are there, and if you the initially two sodium atoms are there and you are removing those two electrons from the sodium atoms, you will write the you will show that electron somewhere, na? You see here two sodium atoms are there. You see the pointer here, two sodium atoms are there, and it is forget about these two electrons, don't forget for the time being, you forget about these two electrons. Here two sodium atoms are there, it is getting converted into two sodium ions. So you have, for that you have to remove two electrons. You have to show that electrons somewhere, na? It will not vanish into air. Will it vanish into
okay,
air?
Why are we putting it on the right side, but then when it comes to chlorine, we're putting it on the left side?
Okay, you try putting it on the left side. Okay, you write just you try you write two sodium and you put on the left side. You put on the left side two electrons and see what happens. Please try. You write 2Na and plus 2E. And what is the product then? 2Na is there. Just a minute. Don't include. For the time being, you write 1Na. Na. And you write one electron on the left hand side. So now what it will become, you write on the right hand side.
Na.
Well, how many electrons are there in Na?
None.
11.
Oh, like altogether 11, yeah.
Huh. And upon 11, you are adding one more electron on the left hand side. Okay. So how many electrons are becoming now?
On which side?
Left hand side, you tell me. Sama, just a minute. Forget for the left hand side. You write an Na on the on the left hand side. You have written Na. You add one electron to it. Okay.
Okay.
So what is the product now? Final when you are adding one electron with sodium, how many electrons it is becoming?
I'm sorry.
Sodium has 11 electrons. Okay. You are adding one electron on the left hand side. So how many electrons are there after this? 11 plus 1, 12. So on the right hand side, now write what will, what is the case now, final case now. Sodium had 11 electrons and you added one more electron to it. So what is sodium becoming now? You write on the right hand side.
Na with 12 electrons.
So what is Na with 12 electrons?
Na plus 2E.
Plus 2E. Plus 2E Any no 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 Sama.
Na plus 2e minus.
If sodium has, is it possible for sodium to gain one more electron? Can sodium gain one more electron?
No.
So if sodium cannot gain so sodium with 12 electrons, that will become sodium minus. If take the hypothetical case, if sodium was able to gain one more electron, it will become sodium minus 11 protons and 12 electrons. If sodium somehow gains 11 protons and 12 electrons, it will gain a minus charge of minus one charge. So it will become sodium minus. Will sodium become sodium minus?
No.
It cannot become sodium minus, na?
Uh-huh.
That is why you cannot add electron to sodium on the left hand side. Sodium.
Yes. On the left hand.
What left hand side? On the left hand side, you have written two sodium atoms. You see here, left hand side. It is two sodium atoms. You see the pointer here. Can you write electron here? Is it possible for can this sodium atom accept electron here?
I understand for sodium. Now, okay. Thank you for helping me understand it, but not for chlorine.
Okay. Just a minute. You answer my question first. Mm-hmm. Here, sodium atoms. Two sodium atoms are there. Is it possible for sodium? Can we write two electrons here? Will sodium accept two electrons?
No.
Why?
Because then it wouldn't be a metal, and it can't accept more than 11. Electrons.
Yeah, sodium cannot accept. Sodium to become stable, sodium has to lose one electron. To gain the octet configuration, sodium has to lose one electron. It cannot gain one electron. Okay. So it is not possible to add electron for sodium here. Fine. It is clear for sodium now?
Yes.
Okay. Now we are proceeding to chlorine. Now, you write chlorine in your notebook. Mm-hmm. And you add one electron with chlorine on the left hand side. So what will chlorine become now?
Cl minus.
Cl minus. Okay. Can chlorine accept one electron?
Yes.
It can accept one electron. That is why you write an electron on the left hand side, because chlorine can accept one electron. And after accepting one electron, chlorine will become Cl minus. That is why for chlorine you write on the left hand side. But sodium cannot accept electron. That is why you cannot write on the left hand side. Okay. I will tell you. Okay, you write Cl minus here. You see, you look at this pointer, Sama. Please look at this pointer. You write Cl minus. In your copy, you write Cl minus on the left hand side. And you add one electron plus on the left hand side, you have written Cl minus. You add plus electron plus E minus. So what will it become? Is it possible?
No, it's not.
Okay. Cl minus, how many electrons Cl minus has?
18.
So Cl minus is possible because it will become, it will have an inert gas configuration. Okay. But with Cl minus, if you add one more electron, how many electrons it will become? 19. So is that possible? Is it possible for chlorine to accept two electrons?
No.
Okay.
Why can't we write it as Cl for the beginning? Because in the equation, it's Cl2. So why can't write a Cl2 arrow Cl minus, two Cl minus, minus E.
Yes, you can write that. You can write that minus 2e. You will write. Okay. You can you what you mean to say? You can you want to write Cl2 it arrow 2 Cl minus minus 2e. Here you want to write.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can write that way.
Oh.
You can write that way. Cl2. You can write this way. Okay. I'm telling you. You mean to say like this? You want to write Cl2 gives C2C minus minus 2 electrons. This way you want to write.
Yeah.
Yes, you can write this. Okay.
Okay.
Now, you can write that, okay, that way you can write. So if you have written that way in mathematics, you can bring something from left hand side to the right hand side, the sign will change. If x plus y is equal to 3, x is equal to 3 minus y. Sama, in your copy, you write please, x plus y is equal to 3.
Oh no, I was just confused on why we didn't write it. Now I understand it.
But now you understand.
Do you want me to write?
Yeah. So Cl2, you can write Cl2 is arrow. It will give 2 Cl minus minus 2 E. So minus 2 is there. Minus 2 E is there. That is also correct. But if you bring minus 2 E2 on the left hand side, minus sign will change into plus. This way you can write. Both ways are right. Okay. Sama,
yes,
are you getting it? Cl2 arrow,
yeah.
2 Cl minus minus 2e. Now if you bring this minus 2e from the right hand side to the left hand side, the sign will change, it will become plus 2e on the left hand side. You can write this way also.
Yeah, I understand.
Is it clear to you now?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So this is how you write the half equations. Now we have written these two half equations. Okay. Now this is equation one, this is equation two. Okay. So if you add the two equations, if you add the two half equations, if you add equation one and equation two, it will give you the ionic equation. Okay. By adding the two half equation, one half equation is for sodium and the second half equation is for chlorine. If you add the two half equations, it will give you the ionic equation. Now I have added equation one and two. So this is finally giving 2Na plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl. Is it clear to you?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay. I will. If you have any doubt, please ask me.
No, it's clear now.
Can you see this screen? Write half equation for K. K plus Br2 gives KBr. You write, please. You write the two half equations for it.
Okay.
You send me on the WhatsApp that half equation that you write. Two half equations are there.
Br2.
Yeah.
After I convert, do I still write the two after the R or do I write it before the B?
Pardon? Br2, yes.
Okay, so after the formula, when I write it in the half equation, I write Br2 arrow. Do I write 2Br or Br2 again?
No, 2Br you will write. 2Br minus you will write. Listen. Now this, what is this? You look at this. This KBr. KBr is a molecule. Okay, it is an ionic compound. KBr. Sama? KBr is an ionic compound. The net charge on KBr is zero. But this, because KBr, we are not writing plus or minus charge because the net charge on KBr is zero. Now individual charge, if you look, this K is K plus, this K is potassium ion, and this Br is Br minus ions. Now this potassium has charge of plus one and this bromine has a charge of minus one. So charge of plus one and charge of minus one, they are neutralizing each other. That is why you are writing KBr, because overall it is neutral overall. But individually, this K has a charge of plus one. You see, K has a charge of plus one and Br has a charge of minus one. Okay. So you write Br2. Br2 is a Br molecule. And what is it giving? It is giving two Br minus. Br minus means Br ion, Br negative ion. So you will write two Br minus. Okay. Is it clear to you?
Yes.
And explain to me why you will write and what you will write.
Because it's not becoming a molecule anymore. It's becoming two of Br minus.
Yes, two of Br minus. We are writing is KBr because overall charge is zero. This potassium has a charge of plus one and Br has a charge of minus one. So plus and minus, overall charge is zero. But individually, potassium has a charge of plus one and bromine has a charge of minus one. Individually, they have a charge of plus and minus one. Overall, this molecule, this KBr is a molecule. The overall charge on the molecule is zero, but Br is Br minus. Okay.
Okay.
So you please.
Or just tell you what I wrote.
You send me on WhatsApp. I want to see. You take your time. Okay. Don't hurry. You take your time. Write it correctly and send me on the WhatsApp. Okay, you have written is right. Okay. Now in the second line, you wrote 2Br minus minus 2 electrons. So can you bring this minus 2 electrons? It is right. What you have written is correct. Okay. But can we rearrange it further? As per your textbook. What you have written is correct. It is totally correct. Okay. What you have written is correct. But can we further rearrange it so that it looks nice? It is correct. So can you bring this minus two electrons of Br on the left hand side?
I can, but it's easier for me to keep it.
No, but okay, it is easier for you, but you should go as per your textbook format only, na? Okay, what you have written is correct. It is totally correct. And it is easier for you, but in that, as per your board exam, the arrangement is that you should write these two electrons. You bring these two electrons on the left hand side. The sign will change. On you have written minus 2e. When it comes to the left hand side, it will become plus 2e. Okay. So you please bring it on the left hand side and send me. Once more, you send me. You have written is it is correct, but just rearrange it. Because we have to follow the format of Cambridge. good, Sama, very good. One thing more you will do. Now you add the two equations. You add the two half equations. Sama?
What does that mean?
Now you see here. I will tell you what it means. This was the equation for sodium, equation 1, and this was the equation for chlorine, equation 2. Now, in mathematics, have you learned to add equations?
Yes.
So you add equation 1 and equation 2. That means you add this sodium, whatever is on the left hand side, you add for the two equations, and what is on the right hand side, you add for the two equations. Add equation 1 and equation 2. It's in your textbook also. Add equation 1 and equation 2. For KBr, you have written two equations, one for potassium and one for bromine. You add the two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. Add whatever is on the left hand side and add whatever is on the right hand side. Okay. For sodium chloride, after adding equation 1 and equation 2, now this is what we had on the left hand side. You see the pointer, and this is what we had on the right hand side. Okay. Now this two electron gets cancelled. So then what is left is this. So you do
just give the same formula as above, 2K plus Br2 equals to 2K Br.
Yes, it will give that only. And it's I am telling you to write it because it is in your textbook also. You look in your chapter 7. Listen, what is the half equation? If you add the two half equation, it will give you the ionic equation. Okay, so by adding the two half equation, what you get is the ionic equation. And listen, ionic equation will give only the elements in which the charge is changing. Remember this. I will illustrate with an example further. So it is important. You please add the two half equations. It will give you the full ionic equation. It's in your textbook also. It's important. There is some difference, I will tell you with suitable example in classes ahead. You add the two equation for KBr and send me. Good, very good, Sama. Very good. You have understood. Now you see this reaction, calcium plus chlorine, it gives calcium chloride. Acha, Sama, can you tell me what is this CaCl2? What do you call this CaCl2?
CaCl2.
What is it? Is it an acid? Yeah, it is calcium chloride. So what is calcium chloride? Is it an acid or base or salt? What is it?
It's a salt.
Yes, good. It is a salt. Why? Because a salt is typically made of a metal and a non-metal. Okay. So this calcium chloride, CaCl2, is a salt. KBr that you just wrote, it is also a salt. NaCl, it is also a salt. Salt is made up of two elements, non-metal and metal. Okay, so you see Ca is a metal and Cl2 is a non-metal, so it is a salt. Okay, so you write the half equation for this CaCl2, please.
CaCl2.
Yeah, you see this equation, Ca. You see? Can you see the screen?
Mm-hmm.
You see this? See the?
I
will. Yeah, I'll scroll down. You see, this is the question. Ca plus Cl2 gives CaCl2. This is the only question. This is the answer. Okay, you write the half equation, mm-hmm. please.
I have a question. When calcium loses two electrons, do I say for the half equation it would be Ca arrow Ca plus plus 2e minus or e minus 2?
Whatever you have written, please send me. I will see.
I haven't written it because I'm not sure.
Okay. Okay. I will tell you. Ca, mm-hmm. tell me. To become stable, what will Ca do? It will lose two electrons.
Mm-hmm.
So calcium, it will give Ca 2 plus plus 2e. One calcium atom is there. This equation is already balanced, you see.
Mm-hmm.
And calcium, sodium gives sodium plus ion. Calcium gives calcium 2 plus ion. Calcium loses two electrons. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So calcium, it will give calcium 2 plus plus 2 electrons. Okay, one atom of calcium, it is giving 2 electrons. Okay, so calcium, it will give calcium 2 plus plus 2 electrons. Is it clear now? And CaCl2 is a molecule. It is made up of one calcium atom having a charge of 2 plus and two ions of chlorine having a charge of minus 1 each. Okay. This is a calcium chloride mm-hmm. molecule, you see on the left hand, right hand side. You see the pointer here, and CaCl2, the overall charge is zero, but individually calcium has a charge of plus 2 and chlorine has a charge of minus 1. So there are two. Okay, right, left side. You, Sama.
Mm-hmm.
In the last part, Ca, you have written Ca plus Cl give Ca Cl. It will Ca yeah, plus sorry, Cl2. Yeah, good. Yeah, yes. Correct it. Correct it and send once more. Again, you have written Ca plus Cl. Give CaCl2. It is Ca plus Cl2. Last line you see. Sama.
Yeah, I corrected it on one side and I forgot about
it. Yeah, please correct it. And send once more. Now it is correct. You write the equation Fe.
Which valency?
Fe Fe plus Cl2 gives FeCl3. You write? That is called ferric chloride. When you write Fe double RIC, ferric, ferric means valency 3. And when you write ferrous, now the symbol of iron is Fe, ferrous. When you write ferrous, Fe double ROUS, the valency is always 2. And when you write Fe double RIC, ferric, ferric means valency of 3. Okay. When you write cuprous, copper, you say in Latin cup. When you write cuprous, the copper has a valency of 2. When you write cupric, it has a valency of 3. Okay. Similarly, when you write ferric, you have a valency of 3. And when you write ferrous, it is a valency of 2. It is ferric here. Valency 3. Okay. Right. Fe plus Cl2 gives FeCl3.
Gives what? Oh, this equation. Okay.
Yeah. I have balanced it, but you should have